Next, let's build our own preset. Go up and hit New. This clears out all the information. We can go to the full browser, click on Samples tab, and now we can start adding our samples to the pools. We can also hit Load to load any sample on our hard drive. Here's what we have so far. We can make some filter selections, and then fine-tune from there if we want to. Let's head over and activate some master effects and the master filter. Add some distortion. Turn up the res. Add some chorus to widen it out a little bit. The default amp envelope is number 5. We can click on it and increase the attack time. Next, let's add some rhythmic movement by modulating that distortion. We'll select a downward sawtooth, and then go ahead and increase the attack time, and we'll map it directly to that distortion effect. Increase the rate. And now we have some nice movement with that distortion. Just like we mapped that LFO, let's map the mod wheel. Click and drag, drop it on the cutoff frequency. And it's just that easy to do a mapping. We can also map that mod wheel to the chorus amount. So when we open up that cutoff frequency, we get more chorus. At the very top in the global panel, we have an intensity knob. And this is straight from ozone. It's a limiter. And we can really fill out the sound. Now that we have something we like, let's save it. Hit save. We can select a category to save it in. And of course, we can name it. You just created your first preset within Iris 2.